Hello everyone, Reza here and welcome to another Unreal Engine tutorial. In this tutorial, we will explore how to generate different camera shakes. As usual, we have a lot to cover, so let's get started. Let's start by introducing the scene. I'm using the Mediterranean coast level, which is free this month on the Epic Marketplace. I've also gone ahead as a prerequisite and set up my level sequencer, placed the camera, and everything is ready for our demo. Now, the first thing I want to do to apply camera shake is obviously to have animation. So I am going to select the scene camera, and right now in transforms, location, rotation and scale, we have no keyframes. I've gone ahead and locked or ticked keep playhead in playback range while scrubbing, so I'm not going before and after the selected time range by accident. I'm going to set the time head at the first frame, and I'm going to go to transform and select all the keys. I keyframe all the keys here. I'm going to go right at the end, and let's use some of these X and Y to move forward like so. I'm going to move this camera down because there's a bit of a slope going on. Let's review and see what we have. Something like that. I can ever so slightly move to this side, and I've got the auto key on, so I don't need to worry about applying keyframes. And that should be good. Ever so slightly moving up, and that should do the trick for us. All right, so let's say the animation is ready. Where to next? Next is to have the camera shake attached to my scene camera actor. So if I click on scene camera actor, track plus track, I have a camera shake, but you can see it's kind of nowhere to be found. We need to make one. You can add a camera shake effect to your camera using Unreal Engine's camera shake blueprint. That means that we need to create a blueprint. I've already made a folder here. I'm going to right click, go to blueprint class. And in all classes, all I need to do is just to look for camera shake base. You can see camera shake base pops up. I'm going to select that, select, and I'm going to call that something meaningful like camera shake and open it up. I don't need to open event graph. I can easily close it up. So we have a bunch of attributes that you need to play around with. Usually the first change I make is within the root shake pattern. You need to specify what type of movement you would like to have, and there are multiple patterns available for you for different types of scenarios. The most common one, especially with this one, is someone's gone bushwalking and there's a handheld camera. That's the type of effect that I'm looking for. Perlin noise camera shake works perfectly fine. And the good thing about Perlin noise is it generates samples, random points over time. It's a bit unpredictable, and you can control the frequency and the amplitude of the noise. And if I go into location, you can see we have location amplitude, location frequency. For rotation, I also have amplitude and frequency. We don't have it for field of view and timing, and I will explain why. But just so you know, these two are key properties, simply because amplitude controls the size of the shake pattern. It intensifies it up and down or left to right. And frequency controls the speed of the shake, how fast the movements are going to be. I noticed that with this particular noise, it works just fine for a handheld type of scenario. But we have more methods. One is sinusoidal sort of wave. You can see wave camera shake. And that is perfect if the character goes up and down. It generates noise over time using continuous wave like a sinus curve and smooth periodic oscillations. So it's perfect if you have the character on a boat in open area like ocean or river and it goes up and down. It's perfect for that. And again, we more or less get the same type of attributes and properties, just a slightly different effect. Then we have a sequence shake in here, sequence camera shake, and that doesn't really give us much of an attribute. You can point towards your camera animation contained in the camera animation sequencer. And it's very useful in cases where you want full control over your camera shake style and behavior. And we've got the craziest of all, composite camera shake. And composite camera shake is without a doubt the most intense one, where it kind of combines purlin, wave, and sequence shake in a layer system. So you can just stack those on top of each other, and it usually results in a very jittery, intense type of shake, which is perfect for scenes like earthquake if you wish to add that. But for now, I'm going to stay with this purlin, and that gives me enough to move forward with what I have. So what I usually do, again, it's a totally taste-based and preference-based type of scenario where you look at your effect in real life, what you would like to get, and change the amplitude and the frequency based upon that. But for my case, I know for a fact that I would like to change the rotation ever so slightly. So I can go into, let's say, 1. And you can compile, save, and see the result immediately. Let's do that, actually, before making too many changes. Now, the question is, I have the blueprint, how to attach that to my cine camera actor. I'm going to click on this plus track, go into camera shake, and select my camera shake. First problem, we notice that it's fairly short, which we can easily fix in timing. So I'm going to go and set that one to, let's say, 100, which is more than enough. The units, the measurements is seconds, so 100 seconds. And then we have blend in time and blend out time. Right at the beginning, it doesn't really have much of a shake, and then it starts shaking and it goes blend out. So if you have a scenario where you cut into a scene and that scene has the camera shake from the first frame, then I highly encourage you to zero that out. And with that, you can see those ramps are gone and we actually get to have the camera shake right at the beginning. Right? I might go ahead and intensify this to 5. Now you can see the camera is kind of crazy. It's going all over the place. Although if someone is running with the handheld camera, that is totally something that you can justify. But for now, I might actually tone this one down to 0.8. And yeah, that is totally acceptable. And I'm going to ever so slightly reduce the roll. Roll also is something that can greatly add to the value of this scene. If you have roll, which is swinging to left and right, so I can increase that to something like 5. And you can see the camera is actually swinging, which is the movement of the wrist, which you can add. But for now, I perhaps reduce it to something like 1.2. So it's not too unsettling. So you can see we have the camera all good to go. I can compile, I can save and close the window. And that's all there is to it for a simple camera shake that you can add to your scene in no time. I hope you found this video useful and use these techniques in your scene. And thank you again for your support. Until the next video, see you guys later.